Hello and welcome to Spectrum. In this video, we're going to discuss a new approach to high-speed signal processing and analysis. It's called SCAP, the Spectrum CUDA Access for Parallel Processing. The old way for signal processing. The first method simply sends the data to the CPU of the host PC. This conventional approach provides an easy solution. Users write their own analysis programs based on the vendor's API, using dedicated measurement software like Spectrum's S-Bench 6 or third-party software like MATLAB and LabVIEW. The overall performance and measurement speed is then limited by the CPU's available resources. In demanding applications, it's a problem, as the CPU shares its processing power with the rest of the PC system, as well as controlling the data transfer. The second approach uses FPGA technology, Field Programmable Gate Array. This is a powerful solution, but it comes with a much higher cost and complexity. Large FPGAs are expensive, and creating custom firmware requires an FDK for the digitizer, tools from the FPGA vendor, and specialized hardware programming engineering skill. Creating firmware isn't for everyone, and even experienced developers can get bogged down in long development cycles. Furthermore, you're always limited by the FPGA that's actually on the digitizer. For example, if the available block RAM is exhausted, there's nothing more you can do. SCAP, a new approach from Spectrum. The Spectrum SCAP approach uses a standard off-the-shelf GPU, graphics processor unit, that's based on NVIDIA's CUDA standard. The GPU connects directly with the digitizer with no more CPU interaction. This opens up the huge parallel core architecture of the GPU for signal processing. The structure of the CUDA card works perfectly for analysis as it is designed for parallel data processing. This makes it ideal for tasks such as data conversion, digital filtering, averaging, baseline suppression, FFT window functions, and even FFTs themselves, as they can easily be handled in parallel. SCAP allows fast data transfer to scalable GPUs that have hundreds or even thousands of processing cores, memories of several gigabytes, and calculation speeds of up to 12 teraflop. A small GPU with 1K cores and 3 teraflop calculating speed is already capable of doing continuous data conversion, multiplexing, windowing, FFT, and averaging at 500 mega samples per second on two channels with an FFT block size of 512K, and it can run for hours. Let's have a look at this example. A Spectrum M4i.4451X8 digitizer, the new SCAP, and a Quadro P2000 GPU turns time domain data into frequency domain using large 1 megapoint FFTs. Here you see the FFT is calculated in only 3 milliseconds. You can even perform FFTs on the fly, averaging them, transferring the average data continuously, and compute high-resolution FFT results. Comparing the SCAP approach to an FPGA-based solution reveals a big saving in the total cost of ownership. All you need is a matching CUDA GPU and the software development kits. However, the largest cost saver is project development time. Instead of spending weeks trying to understand a supplier's FDK, the structure of the FPGA firmware, the FPGA design suite, and the simulation tools, you can start immediately by working with examples written in easy-to-understand C code and using common design tools. SCAP comes complete with a driver extension for remote direct memory access between the digitizer and the GPU, a set of examples for interaction between the digitizer and the CUDA card, working code written in C and C++, allowing CUDA parallel processing with easy building blocks for basic analysis functions like filtering, averaging, demultiplexing, and FFTs. Start with tested and optimized parallel processing examples, and you will get first results in minutes, not months.